First thing we're going to talk about here today is this. You know, we've been discussing lately, Rob, the Doolittle situation and the Doolittle movie. And, you know, this is going to be a movie that some people are going to like. Some people are going to like this movie because that's the subjective nature of film. And that's awesome if they like it. I wish I liked it. However, I did not. I thought it was pretty bad. And for a $175 million film, not including the marketing costs, which you're probably tagging on another $75 to $100 million right there, you're talking about a movie that needs to pull in somewhere around $400 million plus to break even. They're now projecting that with its opening weekend of $22 million, they're projecting, Rob, that Doolittle is going to probably end up, probably, it's not a certainty yet, but is probably at this point going to end up losing more money than Cats did. They're saying it could lose in excess of $100 million. Now, what we as film fans often do is we are desensitized to these giant numbers and we think that's nothing. Oh, it's a big studio. Losing $100 million is nothing. It's something. It's big.
Yes.
There are people who are going to lose jobs over this. There are departments that are going to be shut down over this. This, we're just talking about having a, imagine having $100 million in your lap one day and tomorrow it's gone, Rob. And tomorrow it's gone. I mean, it's kind of like it is right now because I don't have that at the moment. But still, I didn't have it yesterday and today that it's gone. This is a huge, huge loss. And Rob, you got to at this point ask the question, why was this a film that just did not appeal to the audience to come out and give it a shot? Because at a $22 million opening weekend, was it bad marketing? Was it just the concept was an outdated concept? Was it the fact that, you know, people are just still too in tuned with seeing Robert Downey Jr. as Iron Man? Was it the fact of the timing of the, I mean, what was it about this film that just made people look at it and go, meh, not interested? How do you see it?
Well, I think there's a number of things. First of all, I don't know. I was just saying to you how far, you know, they went a long way down the road with this movie and there were a lot of problems. People knew there were problems. There's been articles written about the problematic nature of this film. Stephen Gaghan, the director, good writer, director, never worked with visual effects before. I don't know how he found himself the director's seat for this, what was going to be always an expensive movie. But I have to tell you, even I love my fantasy movies and talking animals, John, I have a thing for talking animals. If they're funny, if there's something about talking animals that it always kind of appeals to me if it's done well. Nothing about this movie appealed to me. And I'm pretty forgiving. I mean, I'm the guy that loves Star Crash after all, but this film did not, I mean, this movie just, you know, you looked at it and you could just tell it wasn't inspired. It didn't look like it was particularly fun. And I understand they're, you know, when you see Robert Downey Jr. As Sherlock Holmes, there's something inherently appealing about that. You could tell from the trailers before you even saw the movie that there was something you wanted to see. This film was a smorgasbord of things I don't think anybody wanted to see. You know,
if you will,
of cornucopia of unappealing elements. And, you know, somebody, there's an article in Forbes magazine about how Robert Downey Jr. is not a movie star. And I don't think that's true.
No, that's not true.
I think that Robert Downey Jr. is, in fact, a movie star. He's been holding the screen for decades now. But you have to put him in the right material. You have to give him something that audiences look at and go, I got to see that. And it's been done before. Look, I went and saw Kiss Kiss Bang Bang for the first time. I know it was Shane Black, but you could just tell that the chemistry between Val Kilmer and Robert Downey Jr., and that was Robert Downey Jr. coming off his, let's call it, The Troubles. You could tell that movie was going to be something I wanted to see. It wasn't a huge success, but it was a really good movie. And every time
it was an awesome movie. It was fantastic. I love that movie.
And that's the movie Favreau saw and said, Downey Jr. can do Iron Man, can be Tony Stark. And I just don't know, how does a big studio get so far down the road? And like you pointed out, maybe they got too far down. They lose less money by finishing than if they just pull the plug. I mean, nobody ever really just pulls the plug on movies. They just keep throwing money at them, hoping somehow they can fix them. And I don't think that's always the best thing to do.
Yeah, I mean, Rob and I were talking about this before the show starts. Like, at what point do you go, listen, this movie is just turning out to be more trouble than it's worth? But think of it this way, too. If it does end up, let's say it, for argument's sake, it ends up losing, I don't know, we're going to pick a wild number, $95 million. Let's say this movie ends up costing $95 million. I would venture a guess that by the time they figured out that this movie was going to be a bit of a disaster, they had probably committed to or invested over $95 million already. So then it becomes financially advantageous to just keep going. I mean, that's the weird thing about the economics in this business, right? So listen, and I don't think this is going to end up being the worst movie of the year or anything. It was filled with all the right intentions. I could see what they were going for. It's just, for me, it didn't work. But there are people out there who are really enjoying, and that's the great thing. Question I have for you guys is, according to the numbers, a lot of you guys didn't go to see this movie. I'm just curious, if you did not go to see Doolittle, what was it specifically about the film that kept you away from it? Was it the concept? Was it the Robert Downey Jr. thing? Did the trailers just not look good? Like, what was it about it that made you go, I'm going to take a pass on it? I'm curious to know your thoughts. Jump down to the comment section below and let me know your thoughts. All right.